Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the U.S. stock market for Friday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures have been up all morning. Dow futures currently up 200 points. The big news story this morning is the price of crude oil, which is up over 5% in the pre-market. Overnight, things look pretty good in Japan. The Nikkei was up over 900 points, drove up to the lower channel line, so no change in trend there. Big reversal from Thursday's trading action. We drove down and closed at the low, and then reversed and closed at the high on Friday. There's an inside day for the Hang Seng. Looking at Shanghai, we bounced off the recent low there. Still trading below the lower channel line. Inside day for Singapore. And the Australian market looks like it put in a low last week. It's trying to drift higher. It's not really making much of an effort here. Notice the resistance up at this level here. And so that's 50-50. So we're going to have trouble getting over that, and we need to get over that to generate a buy signal here. So we're looking for a close above 50.32 on Friday, and just above that is resistance. So that's going to be a little bit of an issue going up for the Australian market. So the world's focus on crude oil once again on Friday. It's up trading in the channel. We need a close above 32.22 on Friday to give us a buy signal for crude oil. Next up, we're looking at the S&P 500, and on Wednesday, we bounced off support at 1812.50. We drove up yesterday, traded through the 1875 level, but didn't close there. So on Friday, we're looking to see if we can break out and close above 1875. We're certainly doing that in the pre-market this morning, but the markets have been disappointed a lot from what has happened between the pre-market and the real market. So we're just 6 points away from 1875. We're going to clear that at the open. Our next target to the upside is 1937.50. Normally, we would expect psychological resistance at 1900, but 1900 didn't play a lot over the past couple of weeks. So it's a straight move up to 1937.50 is our next target to the upside. To generate a buy signal on Friday, we need to close above 1940.49. Of course, that upper channel line is going to continue to move lower on Friday if we don't achieve our goal of a close above that level. Now, the VIX came down on Thursday, and so that's supportive for higher stock prices, but still it's in an uptrend. And so we still need continued movement to the downside for the VIX. There's bonds. The 30-year bond closed lower and had an inside day from Wednesday's trading action. The bonds, the futures contract, actually closed below the stock market. So we saw additional selling going into the close on the TLT. Still on a buy signal here. But of course, we're looking for money to come out of the bond market. And we saw a little bit of that on Thursday. There's the bank stocks, and so the bank stocks had an inside day yesterday and closed at the low of yesterday's trading. So not a lot of excitement in the financial services banking sector from Thursday's trading action. We saw money go back into basic materials, but not into biotech. So it's banks and biotechs were dragging yesterday, and biotechs closed at the low of the day after hitting the lower channel line. Amex Oil and Gas Index was up yesterday. We saw money go back into the XAU, no change there. We saw semiconductors trade up to the lower channel line, and we saw transports trade up and almost get to the lower channel line. Now, I used to talk about my five stocks. I have five stocks that I trade as a basket. I'm either long or short, so this is what I'm looking for right now to liquidate the rest of my short positions and to go long. We need a close on for Alphabet above 742.60 on Friday to give us a buy signal there. For Apple Computer, we need a close above $100.26. For the CME group, and notice it made a new low and closed at that low yesterday, we need to close above 87.36. And for Goldman Sachs, again, closing at the low of the day on Thursday, we need to close above 164.63. And last up, Visa traded up to the lower channel line on Thursday. We need to close on Friday above $74.19. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, and that's all for me for this week. I might be able to do a presentation over the weekend, but nothing on Monday morning. Next time you'll hear my voice in the pre-market is going to be on Tuesday morning. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again soon.